NASA had this crazy idea in the 1960s, which would allow us to produce food from thin air, and it might just be the key to our future. But first, let me fill you in on one of the big problems that humanity is facing right now: agriculture. When you hear the word agriculture, what do you imagine? Maybe a farm, some cornfields, chickens clucking around, cattle eating grass. That's the kind of picture that most people, including myself, imagine where our food comes from. There is another side to this coin though, one that is not so bright. And on this darker side, there are two dark truths about the agricultural industry. The first is the impact agriculture is having on our climate. It may shock you to hear that producing the food we eat spits out more greenhouse gases into the environment than all of the transportation industries combined. Think about that for a moment. All the cars on the road, the airplanes in the sky, all that combined does less harm to the environment than what it takes to produce that bowl of cereal you had this morning. The second dark truth is that it takes up a lot of land to produce the food that you eat. We've cleared about 19.4 million square miles for crops and livestock. And to put that size into perspective, that's roughly the size of South America and Africa combined. Two whole continents. What's even scarier is that we're gonna need even more in the future. Right now, our population is around 7 billion, and by the year 2050, we're estimated to reach a population of 10 billion, so we'll need nearly twice as much food. The problem with agriculture, though, is that it doesn't scale horizontally, meaning if you want to produce more food, you need more land, and with the sea levels rising and deforestation being a major issue, stopping climate change and producing more food seem to be at odds with one another. Here's an example of that. This is the Amazon rainforest. It was on fire earlier this year in 2019. But unlike normal, naturally occurring forest fires, which usually happen from lightning strikes, most of the Amazon fires started this year have been thought to have been started by farmers and loggers clearing land for crops. And for those of you that don't know, the Amazon rainforest is a key player in stopping climate change. Every year, this rainforest absorbs 2 billion tons of carbon dioxide, which is the biggest contributor to climate change. So when we clear out sections of this forest to make room for more farms, we're actually speeding up the process of climate change, which then in turn will melt more glaciers, which then buries more land underwater. It's a lose-lose situation. And for the solution to this thorn of a problem with agriculture, we have to go way back to the 1960s. When a group of NASA scientists published a 145-page scientific report, which included a section detailing their findings in solving one of the big challenges that NASA had to overcome for their long space missions to planets like Mars. That challenge that the NASA scientists were trying to solve was how they could feed a crew of astronauts on long missions spanning 1 to 3 years with limited space and resources. What they discovered as being the most sustainable method to produce food was this. It was to use a special class of microbes that can act like plants in converting carbon dioxide into food. These natural single-celled organisms were called hydrenotrophs. The big idea was to create this closed-loop cycle where the astronauts would exhale carbon dioxide, which produces the food for these microbes to consume. And then these protein-packed microbes would grow at an exponential rate, which would then provide the food these astronauts can eat. And then the cycle repeats itself, with the astronauts pretty much farming their own food using microbes and just breathing. Inspired by NASA's idea from the 1960s, which didn't really go anywhere outside of a research paper, a startup by the name of Air Protein began developing its own process of producing food using microbes. Air Protein grows these microbes in these brewery-like production plants, which use this probiotic production process similar to making yogurt. The microbes are placed in this fermenter where they feast on carbon dioxide and mineral nutrients to produce an ingredient that is 80% protein. This is their final product, which they call Air Protein flour, and it tastes like nothing. The protein flour itself has a neutral flavor, containing all the amino acids necessary for the human diet. And it can be used in several different kinds of food, not just meat-free meats. The company has been exploring using this air protein flour as a replacement for cereal, protein bars, and shakes. Many things make this such a groundbreaking technology compared to the agricultural way of doing things. One is that the protein found in this air-based meat can be made really fast. On the agricultural side, raising chickens and cows takes years of nurturing before they become food, and crops take months to go from seed to harvest. Air protein's probiotic production process doesn't take years or months of nurturing. It's ready to be harvested in a matter of hours. And according to Lisa Dyson, who is the CEO of Air Protein, she's claiming that we can produce so much food with this production process with microbes that you need a farm the size of Texas to give you the same amount of protein that you can get from an air protein production process the size of Walt Disney World. And compared with the way most meats and vegan alternatives are produced right now, air protein powder is made completely naturally without any GMOs, pesticides, herbicides, hormones, and antibiotic injections, which is what we've been getting criticized for in the way we produce most of our food right now. Not only is air protein faster and safer to produce, but it's also a lot more healthy, containing all the same amino acid profiles in beef or chicken, in addition to the many minerals and nutrients that are so hard to get in a vegan diet, like vitamin B12, which is crucial for a healthy nervous system. With the storm of climate change fast approaching, we find ourselves living in a world where we need to reconsider the way we are doing things, because the way we've been doing things got us to where we are right now. Startups like Air Protein are rising to face the challenges by proposing more natural processes rather than scientific ones in the way we produce our food. It's kind of ironic that such a natural process was inspired by a scientific paper published by a space company in the 1960s. It's like they dug up some kind of treasure chest that was buried in the past. It makes you wonder, what other treasures of ideas are buried in the past? Would you ever consider adopting this microbial diet? Let me know in the comments below. And if you liked the video, be sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe with notifications, and I'll see you on the next one.